Welcome to the Comfy Red Couch. My name is Tracy and I'm your host. I'm not sure if you can quite see behind me. Scout has joined me on the couch today. I guess she's wanting some attention. So she is very, very happy to have you here, giving her belly rubs and scratches behind the ear because that's what puppies love, lots of attention, especially golden retriever puppies, who are just adorable. Welcome to this week's episode, and I have a very special thing to talk about today. I went to a workshop this morning, and I'm excited to share information about that. Right now, let me tell you where you can find me. I am Tracy RR on Ravelry, and I am at Comfy Red Couch on Instagram. My neighbor has, I don't know whether, we had a really, really windy night on Halloween, and I don't know whether one of his trees fell down or whether he was having a tree cut down, but a couple doors over when I came back from my workshop, there was one of those tree grinders set up in front of his house, and as soon as I sat down ready to podcast, the grinder went on and started shredding the trees into little bits. So not sure what happened there, but I'm thinking they are done now. I'm hoping, crossing my fingers. Anyway, welcome to this week's podcast. If you are a new viewer, welcome. This is a podcast that I primarily chatter away about knitting and the knitting that I have or maybe haven't gotten up to over the past week. And if you are new, this is Scout. She sometimes joins us on the podcast, but usually it's just me. And if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. I know you are happy to see Scout because she is just adorable. She's going to start pawing me in a few moments though and wanting my attention, but I'm trying to give it to you because you are my guest, our guest. And I am excited to let you know about some of the things that I've gotten up to this week. So welcome back. I know that you have your requisite cup of whatever it is you are drinking. I know you have your project of choice and that you have chosen a spot either on the couch or the chairs and you are happy to just settle down for a little bit as you do some self-care and listen to me chatter about what I've gotten up to this week. And I have gotten a few things worked on this week, and I've even finished a project, which just feels so good. I have been doing a lot of secret knitting, so only little tiny bits to share with you, but I do get to share yarn, so that is always an exciting thing. So let's start off with some tea time. And this week, I am drinking the first cup of tea that I made myself this morning, but I haven't even opened it yet. So it is a few hours old and it'll still be piping hot. This is Apricot Dream and I am drinking it out of my Timolina, which is my travel mug. I love these cups because you can turn them upside down, although I'm probably going to regret this in a moment when I open it. It can be thrown in your bag as long as it is secured and you've got those caps on there, you're good to go. So today, as I said, I am drinking Tea Palace Apricot Dream. And really, you want outside now? You could have gone out earlier, but no, you want out now? Tea time will have to wait for a moment while I let the puppy outside to go to the bathroom. I can understand with the grinding trees that were happening, it would be very scary to go out there when it was that loud. It was pretty loud. Right back. And then we'll have some tea time. The great thing about having to let Scout out to go to the bathroom was that I was able to grab the tea that I am drinking. And this is the Tea Palace and I am drinking Apricot Dream. I have been trying to reduce my tea stash and I'm getting there. So it is a black tea that smells absolutely gorgeous, like apricots. And it has some, I think, marigold petals and some other lovely, good, yummy things in there. So that is what I am drinking. And as I said, I am drinking out of my Timolina, which is my travel mug. I've got a couple of travel mugs that I take to work with me every day. And it is now time to say cheers. My goodness, can you believe it is already November? So let us cheer to a wonderful November. I hope it doesn't get cold too quickly. So cheers to November. And yes, it is still hot, 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 even though I made it many hours ago, but it's delicious. I kind of cheated this morning because I did go to the Purple Pearl for a workshop and I was given lots of Earl Grey tea. So I've already had a couple cups of Earl Grey tea and now I am just drinking the tea that I was going to drink on the streetcar home, but now I thought I'd save it for the podcast. So my apricot dream is waiting to the side and it's just really good. So it is now time to tell you about some of the knitting that I have gotten up to this week. And for some of it, some of it is secret knitting, but I'm going to start off with something I shared with you last week. Last week, I ripped out a project that I had been working on for quite some time, and I decided that I was going to repurpose that yarn, and I was going to make the Persephone mittens and the mitten liners, which are both from the Knits About Winter book by Emily Foden. And last weekend, after I ripped it all out, I chose a beautiful Christmassy project bag because this is going to be my Christmas Eve cast on. And I will be using, oops, there is a needle there, gotta be careful with that. This is Viola Sock in the colorway Ghost. And this is what got pulled out. And I will be making, and this will be for the Persephone mittens. And then I am going to use this gorgeous remaining bit of yarn that I have from knitting the Inkling shawl, and I'm going to use these for my mitten liners. So the mittens and the mitten liners, and I just think those little pops of color will be so fun coming out of the Persephone mitts. So last week, as I was uploading, I realized I had referenced a bunch of other patterns, but I had not referenced the Persephone mittens, and I will make sure that I have done so for this little segment. So, Christmas Eve cast on. My needles are in here. My yarn is in here. The bag is chosen. All we need now is for December to roll around. So that is one of the projects that will be in my future. And I'll put it aside in my little whip section, ready to cast on Christmas Eve. And speaking of Christmas, let me share what yarn I have been using for Knit Event 1. So I did notice in Ravelry, there was a little section of, that has the spoilers for the Knit Event projects, and the yarn for the first project has been mentioned. Now I am doing something a little bit different, which I talked about last week, and I did talk about the fact I'm using my gorgeous bird leg bags Christmas bag for the first project. It is now done. It is blocked. I've taken a couple of photographs, but unfortunately it was a very, very gray day and I didn't get some great photographs, so I'm going to need to take some more photos. But the yarn that I have used, where Helen has used Tundra, which is a bulky weight yarn, a chunky, very, very chunky, I am using Juniper Moon Farms, and I am using the Moonshine yarns, which are more of a worsted weight, but they're a nice thick and fluffy worsted weight yarn. And where Helen has gone with one color, I have actually gone with four. So doing things a little bit different, as I like to do. Now, I needed some yarn for my workshop this week. So the amount of yarn that I have left here is actually not representative of the amount of yarn that I use, other than the charcoal. This is all the charcoal I had left at the end of knitting Knit Vent 1, and I may do something with these, I haven't quite decided. But I used these gorgeous blues ivory with the charcoal, and I actually went in this order as I knit Knit Vent 1. So I think you're gonna like it. It's a great project. Now, because I did use a thinner yarn, I did use a smaller needle size as well. I'm really quite pleased with how my fabric has turned out. And yes, it will be smaller than if I had done a chunky weight project, but for what this project is, I'm really quite pleased with it. And oh my goodness, I really love using Moonshine. It is wool, alpaca, and silk, and it's just such a nice, soft, and cozy blend. The silk adds a little bit of shine to it, and these colors are just so, so lovely, especially this blue right there. This one's nice too, but this blue just makes my heart sing. So these are the yarns that I have used for Knit Vent 1. Scout is a very smart dog. She knows how to let herself in. She paws at the back door and gets herself in. And here she comes, see? You are such a smart puppy. You've let yourself, well, I have to let her out because the door was locked, but she does know how to let herself in and out because she's a smart girl. So that is the yarn that I have used for Knit Vent 1. Now, I mentioned that I did a workshop today. And for that workshop, we had some homework. Are you coming up? Come on up. Come on up. Pop, pop. Good girl. Good girl. And for that workshop, we had some homework. We needed to knit. It was a steeking workshop. So we knit a coffee mug holder. And then we put a little section, a little steek section in there. And we cut that. We cut our knitting. I wasn't too freaked out about the cutting of the knitting because, of course, if you have done socks and you have put in an afterthought heel, actually, I find that a little bit more terrifying than cutting something that you have actually specifically created extra fabric for to steek. So I learned to steek today. So that was very, very exciting. Now, our homework was to make this coffee cup holder. And my very first one was this one here, but the problem is I did not get gauge, and it was very specific that we needed to get gauge on our coffee cup holders because I guess we don't want our coffee cup holders to be super loose. Although some coffee cups, like this one, and there's a paper version, they've got a little bit more of a give to them. You've got a little bit more forgiveness happening there. But it was very, very particular in our instructions that we needed to get to gauge. So I did one, two, still didn't get gauge. And then finally, I did my third one, and I just did them all in different colors with the yarn that I had because that was the yarn that I had. And we were told not to do it in superwash, and I just don't have a lot of worsted weight in my stash. It was really great that I had just finished Knit Vent 1, and then I was able to do this as, use this yarn as a homework project. So here was my yarn where it got cut, and then we reinforced the little steek section, and then we put button bands on the ends. So I now, because apparently I must be an overachiever that I have three of them, I now have 3 little coffee cup mug cardigans, or coffee cup cardigans, that's what they are, with cute little button bands. And actually, this was just, it was great for cutting the knitting, but for me, this was actually a much better workshop for working on buttonholes and button bands and just doing that finishing bit. So this is the one where I got gauge, and just, I was really quite proud of myself. I thought my button bands turned out quite nicely, and with the mixture of colors, I had a lot of fun doing it. So it was definitely a worthwhile project to, or worthwhile workshop to take, and it was taught by Kate Atherley, who really does fantastic workshops. We are very lucky in Toronto to be able to have her do as many workshops as she does. And if you ever have the chance to take a workshop with Kate, you will not be disappointed. I've taken many over the years. I've done 4 different sock workshops. I have done the finishing techniques workshop. I have now done steeking, and I think I've done mittens, all sorts of workshops. It's nice to take them just every once in a while, learn something new. And every single workshop, I learn some new trick or tip. So just definitely a nice thing to do. And I had my eye on this workshop for quite a while. I think it was listed at the end of August or early September. And I had my eye, and I kept sort of looking back, thinking, should I take it? Shouldn't I? I have commitment issues. Anyway, last weekend I saw that Kate had put on her Instagram page that there were still spots left, and then the Purple Pearl also put that there were still spots left, and I knew that if I didn't commit, then I wasn't going to be able to take that workshop because I was the last one to sign up for the workshop. But got a spot. It was a great workshop, definitely a great skill to have. And I now have these cute little coffee mug holders, which I'm going to put aside for now because they are going to play into brown paper packages and a little bit later on. So that is what has been living in my, it was 2 projects. It was KnitVent 1, and it was my cute little coffee cup holders, all in my wonderful Christmas bag, which actually makes up for the project that I am working on now for KnitVent. And it does not have a project bag. It is just on the knitting table because it is using more than one yarn, and I'm trying to keep the yarn organized. So rather than throwing it into a bag where it's going to get all messed up, it's in front of me. So I am working on, I'm not sure if it's KnitVent 2 or whether it will be one of the other KnitVent projects that come out a little bit later, but it is a nice knit, very simple, great for TV knitting. And so that's another project that I have been working on, but I don't have a bag to share with you. So it's on the knitting table. And maybe next week I'll be able to share my yarns with you for that one. And I am using more than one yarn. Gotta keep them straight so they are in front of me. The final project that I am going to talk about is in Nancy Drew. And she's looking a little bit flat. And that is because Nancy Drew is now a finished object. I finished Nancy's project last week. And Nancy wants to share a little bit of information about her project, just a little tiny bit. And that is the yarn that I have used for this project. So this is destined for a November release, from what I understand, and maybe in the next 2 weeks. This project will hopefully, I'll be able to share it with you, and I'm very excited to do so. So this is a project where I used some gorgeous, gorgeous yarn, and it is Nora George Yarns Super Sock Minis, and this was my spring bouquet set of five minis, and this was a yarn that I bought in honor of the royal wedding a couple of years ago, so between Harry and Meghan. And there should be five things of yarn here. So there is a gorgeous peach. There is a gorgeous pink. There is a gorgeous sort of yellowy green. And I almost think it's more on the greenish side, but it does have that lovely sort of yellow tinge to it too, but more green, which makes me happy. There is a lovely blue. And then the final is this gorgeous, gorgeous purple. But let me share a little bit about this gorgeous purple. I was playing a little bit of yarn chicken because I basically have an arm's length of yarn left from this project. So it is a great project. And if you, when you see it, because it is just absolutely adorable, when you see it, just be aware that you may need to be very, very yarn conscious about the color you use in a particular section of the pattern. And you could do a couple of things. You could just maybe knit a little bit tighter, which is what I ended up doing in the sections that I needed the purple. You could, and that was, my gauge was a little bit loose on the entire project. Now I know that there have been three people that have tested this pattern, and then the designer as well. So I believe there's going to be four samples, and three of us were a little bit tenuous about how much yarn we had left. And the designer had enough yarn left. So I guess it depends on how tightly you knit. I have about a meter left. So it's just such a pretty, pretty color. So just, it is a gorgeous pattern. Just when you're choosing your colors, maybe if you're a little bit worried, if you've got a loose gauge, just be aware of your yardage for your yarns. But I was able to use this gorgeous spring bouquet. And I have to say, I saw this pattern back in late spring, early summer. And I just, as soon as I saw it, I knew exactly which yarns that I wanted to use. I knew I wanted to use the spring bouquet. And a lot of that might have been just the time of year. But I have to tell you that since I've been knitting it in October and in the fall, it's felt a really, like, really quite springy to me. So, I mean, these will be great for, this pattern will be great for wearing in deep winter when I'm needing that bit of a spring thaw. But it's interesting to see how your color choices change throughout the year. And I think if I had seen this pattern now, I likely would have gone with more Christmas colors. And I think I would have gone with red, white, and green. Sparkly, sparkly, definitely. And instead of using five, I just would have used more of red, white, and green. I think that would look really fantastic. But yeah, I as soon as I saw it, I knew I wanted to do it in the spring bouquet. But as the fall has progressed, I've been feeling a little bit out of season right now, but that's okay. They'll come back into season. And I just think it's a lovely pattern, and I cannot wait to share it with you. And Nancy, she has blabbed today, hasn't she? Anyway, that is what she has been hiding for a little while now. And hopefully soon she'll be able to share the project that those gorgeous little minis made up. There were ends, though. I will tell you, there were ends. But they're all secured, so it is all good. Anyway, that is all I have to share on my favorite things. It is now time for brown paper packages, and up until this morning, I actually was not going to have a brown paper packages section at all because nothing came in the mail this week, which is okay. But when you go to the Purple Pearl and you are surrounded by gorgeous, gorgeous yarn and all of those yarn fumes are swirling around you as you are steeking away and cutting your knitting, and you know, some people might think that's stressful, so you know, you might want to, you know, ease that, you know, burden by buying some yarn. And when you have a 10% student discount because you took a course, yeah, sometimes you ease the burden and buy some yarn. So that is what I did today. First off, though, I bought some buttons, and these are just the cutest little buttons, and they have a shank on them. I was going to go with different buttons for each of the different coffee cup holders, but I just love these little flamingos so much that I decided each of them was going to get, each coffee cup holder was going to get the same button because they're just too cute. And I'll show those to you in a few minutes. But while I was there, the wall of Shibui was right behind me, and at one point I turned around and I saw this gorgeous combination. So how I made it out of there with only one skein of Shibui Silk Cloud, I have no idea. But this skein of gorgeousness made its way into my bag after paying for it, of course, and came home with me. I believe this is the color Imperial. I can't read it, but I probably should have put my glasses on to read it. I think it's Imperial. Now, I had seen it. Yes, Imperial. And it is this gorgeous, gorgeous purple. Oh, when you go to the Purple Pearl, you must buy purple yarn. So there we go. I did what I was supposed to do. Anyway, this gorgeous skein of Imperial was right beside Raspberry. And the two of them had that real sort of Cheshire Cat look together. But I do have a skein of Petal, which is also a gorgeous pink, which I think will have that Cheshire look as well, and maybe a little bit more of a difference between the two. So I may knit those two together. I also have, I think it's Graphite, that I won last year at the Purple Pearl anniversary party. So maybe I will hold this double with the graphite, or not double, but side by side with the graphite, and make something just scrumptious. I'm not sure. I did not need any more yarn, but oh, it was very, very hard to resist. So yes, this little brown paper package came home with me. It called to me, along with the buttons. So anyway, that is what I have to share on brown paper packages. So now I'm going to move on. And a couple of weeks ago, I was given a lovely poster that I was able to keep one for myself, and I am able to give one away in a giveaway. And I was thinking, I said I was going to think about what I wanted to do for the giveaway. So I think I finally figured it out. And the poster that I am talking about is this gorgeous poster that was given to me by Lorna, and her daughter Ailey made this lovely little print. And it says that all yarn is wool, but not all wool is yarn. No, all yarn is wool. No, all wool is yarn, but not all yarn is wool. if I had my glasses on, I probably could have read it properly the first time. But no, no, why put my glasses on? Anyway, this gorgeous little poster that has llamas and alpacas and sheep and yak and furry, furry little animals, rabbits, angora rabbits. Someone will get this. And I am going to finish off this cute little coffee mug holder that I put buttonholes in, and I'm going to put the flamingo buttons on, and then I will enclose some amazing sachets of Sloan tea as well. So a little giveaway with a gorgeous little print, a coffee mug warmer, and with the cute little buttons on it, which I'll share in a few moments, and then some Sloan sachets of the Heavenly Cream Tea. That's my absolute favorite Sloan tea, and so I will pop those into a nice little envelope for a lucky winner. And what I thought I would do is I will open a thread on Ravelry. And if you would like to win this print, this, it will all be finished. You won't have to do the ends. I'll have it all done for you. And then some gorgeous Sloan tea. All I am asking you to do is to go to the thread that I'm going to create on Ravelry. And that thread will be to share your favorite project that you have ever worked on. So something that maybe you think it's turned out the best and that's why it's your favorite, or whether it is a pattern that for whatever reason, what your favorite project has been, whether it's the yarn, because of the yarn, whatever it is, just share your project that you think is your absolute best favorite, whatever you want to say, and I will then draw for these from the Ravelry entries. So just a simple little giveaway, but something fun going into the winter. So a nice little November treat. And as I said, I am going to put these gorgeous little flamingo buttons on. And just to show you, I've got a cute little shank on them. Just how cute is that button on? Oops. Not so cute when I drop it on the ground. Ah. Anyway. Very, very cute little flamingo buttons to infuse a little bit of spring, summer into November, fall. So, if you would like to win a handmade coffee cup warmer, coffee cup cardigan with flamingo buttons, and a gorgeous print by Ailey, donated by Lorna, the lovely Lorna, and some wonderful, wonderful Sloan sachet bags, just pop over to the Comfy Red Couch Ravelry group and find that little section where you can tell me all about your favorite project. And I think we will even have it open to chatter. And so if you want to chatter, I think I'm just going to randomly pick whether it's if you're involved in the chatter, but please definitely do share what your favorite project is. And yeah, it'll just be a random post, whether it is something that has something shared or whether it's, hey, great job, whatever. So it'll be just nice to have a thread happening that I will have to pay attention to. So I think these are going to be so cute once they're all finished up. And I'll share those with you next week because my plan is to get the buttons sewn on, all three, and better not lose a button in the meantime. And I think that'll be just such a cute little giveaway, something different. Anyway, that is all I have in my basket, and yes, a skein of Shibui Silk Cloud, some buttons, some fun little projects. That's enough. It's now time for Bits and Bobs, and this is my segment where I talk about anything and everything that is not necessarily knitting related. And as usual, I am completely surprised at how quickly November has come. I keep wondering, where did October go? It was Halloween last week, and it is hard to believe that we are already past Halloween, and we will be gearing up for Christmas and all of the festivities. And if you are an American friend, you will be celebrating Thanksgiving as well. So it's a busy couple of months before us, and I know it will fly because it always does. But yeah, it's hard to believe that the weather is really, really changing. And earlier this week, there were leaves on my oak tree. On Halloween night, it was a dreadful night. It was rainy all day long and rainy into the evening. There was a little tiny bit of a lull where the trick-or-treaters were able to go out, and I was at the door, and I did not want to be standing outside, which is where we usually go out onto the porch. And rather than answering the door every couple of minutes when somebody knocks, it's just easier to go stand on the porch and dole out the candy. And usually on a nice night, it's not a bad thing to do, but it was rainy and it was gross and it was windy. And I was just reaching into the bag and giving handfuls of candy. And we didn't just have our own stash of candy to give out. My neighbor had her bridge game, so she gave me all of the candy that she had bought as well. So I was out there for a lot longer than I would have liked to have been, giving out handfuls of candy. And I was very, very happy. There weren't a lot of trick-or-treaters this year. And one thing I have noticed, our street is usually quite full. We've got tons and tons of people. The weather hampered it. We used to have a street show, and it was like light, sound, stage. It was they'd have to close down the road. It was a huge show, and a couple of years ago. So last year was the first year they hadn't done it, and then this year they didn't do it again. So I guess our street will slowly start to peter out from the numbers that we used to have because the stage show no longer draws the crowd. So, which maybe is a good thing, but yeah, it was rainy. Nathaniel went out, and he was maybe out for half an hour, not very long, but he got some little goodies. He decided that he wanted to dress up like Jeff Probst from Survivor, and he had his little snuffer that we made out of a Tim Horton cup, which is why I still have this one. I brought it home from work so that he could use it for the snuffer, but we ended up using a smaller size cup that my coworker had at work as well, because she goes with smaller. This is my large. I need a large. So I put some tissue paper, blue tissue paper, and then we wrapped some pipe cleaners around it. And I'll go grab it, actually. So Jeff Probst always wears a blue shirt and usually khakis, you know, just cargo type pants. So Nathaniel had a blue shirt on, and then he had his snuffer. And this was a pointer that my sister-in-law had given me. And there's this little hand, actually. This is a finger that it's like a board pointer. So we attached the cup. We just taped the cup on. And then I covered it with the tissue paper and taped it in place. And then for sparkle, and because we knew it was going to rain, I had some blue nail polish that was sparkly inside. And I started originally just doing something on the top, and then I decided that it would be better just to do the whole snuffer in the nail polish. So yes, it's got a coating of sparkly blue nail polish on top of the blue tissue paper. And then we just put pipe cleaners and twisted them. And then down this here is like a snake sort of pipe cleaner. And then because it was a little rough at the end here, we just put some tape and some blue tissue paper. So that was the extent of my Halloween planning, but the tribe has spoken. Halloween is over. My costume making has been voted off the island. Just the way it is. Anyway, he did have a good time going to school, and I don't know whether he was telling everybody they were voted off the island or not, but that was his costume. And Isaac wasn't home this year because he is at college. I FaceTimed with him. He had black nail polish on, and he was pretending he was a mall cop. I don't know why black nail polish and mall cop, but he has his scooter with him, so he was apparently riding around on his scooter with his mall cop uniform and blue shirt. And when Nathaniel went to go out for Halloween, I was home doing the door, and Greg was a little bit later getting home that night, and it was after dark by the time he got home. And when Greg got out of the car, Greg was also wearing a blue shirt and tan pants. So the two of them, all that Greg was missing was the snuffer. He took an umbrella out with him instead. So Nathaniel had the snuffer, Greg had the umbrella, and then they both looked alike, except of course it was cold, so Nathaniel had to put a coat over top of his costume, which is defeats the purpose. Anyway, yes, it was Halloween. This is Halloween, and yes, we are ready to prepare for next Halloween. Isaac used to always choose out his hat, like the day after Halloween, Isaac would always know exactly what he was going to be the next year. Nathaniel's not like that at all. Nathaniel, the week before, it's, what are you doing for Halloween? Oh, I don't know. And he had told me, actually, he was going to be Jeff Probst a couple weeks before Halloween, but I had forgotten because it was a simple costume, I thought, very easy to make, so which was sometimes a very, very good thing. So, Steaking Workshop, Halloween, we are now going into November, and I started to say about how it was so windy on Halloween that the day before Halloween, my oak tree out front had quite a few leaves on it, and on November 1st, many of those leaves are gone. There's still a few hanging on the tree as I look at it outside now, but a good chunk of those oak tree leaves are now on the ground, which probably will make for some good photographs for KnitVent, so I should go out and do that. Anyway, I think that is all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs. It was another week, November, cold, it's getting cold. Get to wear those nice fluffy scarves and shawls and wear mohair all underneath them on your clothes, because that's the fun of it, right? Anyway, that is, I think, all I've got to share on Bits and Bobs this week. Thank you so much for joining me on the Comfy Red Couch this week. I hope that you've had a chance to just sit down and relax, work on that project that you have been dying to just give a little bit of love to, and that you have been enjoying your hot beverage, not in a travel mug, but maybe a travel mug. It's a mug. Anyway, I hope that you have had a wonderful week and that you are ready for a wonderful week ahead. I have enjoyed chattering with you about secret knitting. I have enjoyed chattering with you about my Steaking Workshop, and I am excited to start reading your responses for our contest to win this poster, the coffee cup cardigan, and some lovely little tea sachets. And I think I'm going to keep the thread in Ravelry open, and I will draw for a winner on November 17th. So you've got about 2 weeks to share a project that is your favorite for whatever reason, whether it is it keeps you warm in the winter, whether it's because you love the color, whether it's because it is just the best pattern you have ever knit. And as I said, it will be an open chatter thread, so you can give feedback to other people, and any of the responses in that thread will be eligible for a prize of print, coffee cup cardigan, and some lovely Sloan tea sachets in Heavenly Cream, because that's my favorite flavor. Anyway, I am wishing you a wonderful week ahead. I am wishing you a wonderful November, and I look forward to seeing you next week on the Comfy Red Couch. Bye. It is super difficult to podcast when your neighbor is busy grinding down trees. I need headphones.